Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. In this tutorial, we will continue where we stopped in the last tutorial. Go and open the file 00_021_DIAB where you saved it. Or you can go and download this file from the website. If you don't have access to this file, just sit down and watch. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. Save this file to 00_022_DIAB. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click this down arrow. Turn on the current layer and select it to make it the current layer. Right-click the UCS and select the object option. At the prompt select object, select this line. Now, right-click the UCS again. Select the rotate axis option and select the X-axis and move the Y-axis in this direction. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At the prompt, start the polyline from this corner to hold down your shift key to temporarily deactivate the auto mode and snap at this vertex. Move your mouse cursor down and snap at this end point. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the line that you just draw and the bottom line. Right click into the drawing area, isolate object. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 2D polyline command. At the prompt, start the polyline from this endpoint, move the mouse cursor, hover the mouse cursor into this direction, type 3 feet, 1 inch, press enter. Press enter to end the command. Press enter to start the polyline command again. At the specified start point prompt, click here, move the mouse cursor into this direction, and type 3 feet, 1 inch, and press enter to end the command. Now select this line. Right click into the drawing area, isolate hide object. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Select this object and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the polyline command. At the specifying base point prompt, zoom in into this area and click at this endpoint. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and click the down arrow after modify. Select the mirror command. At the specified first point of mirror line, click at the top. At the specified second point of mirror line, move the mouse cursor down and click. Press enter to accept the default snap option. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M for multiple and press enter. Now fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Type join on your keyboard. Use a window selection and press enter. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude from, select this polyline, press enter. Move the mouse cursor to the positive Z axis and type 1 inch, press enter. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. Now we need to get rid of this other part of the fascia board. To do that, let's draw some temporal lines. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Zoom in into this area and draw a line from this vertex. Move it now and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Press enter to get out of the command. Start the line command again and start another line from this area. Move it down and type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Press enter to get out of the command. Now select this fascia board and the two lines that you just draw. Right click into the drawing area, isolate object. Now select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. Click into this endpoint and move the mouse cursor into the positive Z direction. Make sure that the auto mode is turned on. type 3 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the box command. At the specified first corner prompt, click on at the end point of this line. At the specified other corner prompt, click at the end point of this line. Now move your mouse cursor down and snap it to the end point of this line. Select the solid that you just draw and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. Click anywhere into drawing area, move into the Z direction and type 6 inches. Press enter. Now go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the subtract command. Select this object, press enter and select this object. Press enter. AutoCAD subtracts the object. Select this temporal line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now right click, isolate end object isolation. So we need to move this fisher board into position. Select this fisher board, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. Click anywhere in the drawing, move into this direction and type 5 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. AutoCAD move the object into the right location. Now we need to fill in these gaps. To fill in these gaps, go to the home tab, layer panel and click the isolate command. Select this line and this solid. Press enter. AutoCAD isolates the layer. AutoCAD isolates all the objects are in the object layer that you select. So we need to clean up this area to fill in this gap and cut off this excess. So first let's try to fill in this gap. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the union command. Select this solid, this solid, this solid. Press enter. AutoCAD unites this object. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the union command. Select this object, this object and press enter to unite them. Press enter to start the union command again. Select this object, this object, this object. Press enter. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the line command. Start the line from this point and move it to the vertical direction. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the press pull command. Click on this area and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 1 inch and press enter. AutoCAD clean up that area. Do the same thing for this corner. Add a line from this point to this point. Press escape. Select the press pull command and press this area. Zoom in into this other area. Start a line. Click the line command and move it into this direction. Press enter. Start the line command. From this point, move the line down or up. Select the press pull command. Select this face and press it out. Select this face, press it in. Escape. Select this line. This line and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Draw another temporal line from this point and move it down. Press escape. Select the press pull command. Press this area and move it out. Press escape to get out of the command. Hover the mouse cursor into this area. Now move in this direction and type 1 inch. Press enter. Move up. Press escape. Use the press pull command to press this area. Press escape. Select this line and erase it. Start the line command and draw a temporal line. Press escape. Use the press pull command to press press escape, select this line and erase it. Select the line command, start a line from this point to this point, press escape and use the press pull command. Press this object inside, press escape to get out of the command. Delete this line. Select and delete the temporal line that you draw to clean up the drawing. Press escape. Draw another temporal line from this point to this point. Press escape. From this point to this point. Right click on the UCS and select the face option. Hover the mouse also into this face. Press enter to accept. Select the press pull command and press this area. Type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, erase it. Right click the UCS and select face. Hover the mouse cursor into this face. Accept. Press enter to accept. Now select the line command. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Click on this area, move and mouse and turn off the auto mode. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and type 8 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape. Press enter to start the line command again. Hover the mouse cursor into this vertex. Type 8 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape. Now right click the UCS and select the axis rotation option, X axis. Turn on the auto mode and move the Y axis into this direction. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Start the polyline at this vertex. Click on this vertex. Right click this and select the face option. Select this face. Press enter to accept and use the press pull into this area. Move the mouse cursor and type 1 inch. Press enter. Move the mouse cursor inside. Type 1 inch. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click the UCS and select the face option. Select this face. Press enter to accept. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Zoom in into the orbit to this area and zoom in. Click into this vertex. Move your mouse cursor and hover it to this vertex. Turn off the auto mode. Hover the mouse cursor into this vertex and type 12 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the press pull command. Select this area and move the cursor inside. Type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel and select the union command. Select this object, this object, this object, this object, this object. This object, this object. You can hold down your shift key and select to deselect a selection that you don't want. Press enter. AutoCAD unite all the objects into one object. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Draw a temporal line from this point. Turn on your auto mode if it's off and move it up. Press escape. Press enter to repeat the line command. Hold down your shift key and orbit to to get a better orientation, start a line from this vertex and move it up into the Z direction. Press escape. Select the UCS and select the face option. Click on this face, press enter to accept and use the press pull command. Click here and move the mouse cursor inside, type 1 inch and press enter. Hover the mouse cursor into this area, click, move the mouse cursor inside, type 1 inch and press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select face. Hover the mouse cursor into this face and click. Enter an option. Press enter to accept. Right click the UCS and select rotate axis. Select the X option. Now rotate the Y axis so that the Y point where was the Z axis. Start the line command. Zoom in into this area and click. Move the mouse up and click. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Click inside this area and move the mouse cursor outside and type 1 inch, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select this object, press enter. Select the union command again, select this object, press enter. Hold down your shift key and orbit around to see if there is any object that needs to unite in this fisher board. Select the union command, select the fisher board and select this wedge, press enter. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Now, right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation, and go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the on isolate command. Go to the layer panel again and click the all layer button and turn on all the other layers. We still have some job to do into this area. We need to close this gap and see how best we can do to correct these problems. You see, this fisher board need to move up and this gap need to be closed up. Select this object, right click and select isolate objects. Now zoom in into this area. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the first pull command. Select this face and press pull it into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified first point prompt, click on this area. Now move the mouse cursor into this orbit and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 2 feet, 6 inches, press enter. Then move the mouse cursor into the Z direction. Click to place this. Select the line command again. Start the draw line from this vertex and turn off your auto mode and this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Click inside this figure and move the mouse cursor inside. type 1 inch and press enter. Click inside this figure and select this face to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Now orbit into this area and start the line command. Click on this vertex, activate the auto mode and move the mouse cursor into this area and click. Press escape. Start the line command again. Move the mouse cursor into this area, move up, press escape. Press enter to start the line command. Start the line from this point and turn off your auto mode. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and enter a distance of 1 foot. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now right click the UCS and select the face option. Hover the UCS into this area and click. Press enter to accept. Select the press tool command and press this area. Type 1 inch, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this temporal line, this line, and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line, right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select this object, this object, this object, and press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. Orbit into this area. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and start the line command. At the specified start point prompt, click on this vertex. Turn on your auto mode if your auto is not on. Move your mouse into this direction, type 2 feet 6 inches, press enter. Move the mouse cursor up and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Start the line command again and use this vertex as a starting point. Move the mouse cursor into this vertex and move down into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this object, right click, and select the hide object button. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press enter to end the command. Type join on your keyboard. Select this line, press enter. Go to the home tab, model panel, and select the extrude command. Select this line, press enter. Move the line to this direction and type 1 inch, press enter. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select the fissure board and select this red solid and this solid. Press enter. Go to the custom view and select the SE isometric view. Zoom in into this area and click the save icon. Alright, in this tutorial we'll finish our fissure board. In the next tutorial we'll start to grit the soffit and raise the gable and the attic wall. If you found this tutorial useful, please like and share it to your friends. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial for yourself, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class.